We want to evaluate the integrals below by interpreting it in terms of areas in the figure, where we can model a def integral as the area bounded by the function in the x-axis, but if the area is above the x-axis, the value would be positive. If the area is below the x-axis, the value would be negative. So looking at our diagram here, notice on the interval from 0 to 3, the area is above the x-axis, so the def integral would be positive. But notice on the interval from 3 to 5, the area is below the x-axis, and therefore the def integral would be negative over this interval. And then on the interval from 5 to 7, the area is above the x-axis, and therefore on this interval, the def integral would be positive. Another way to think of this would be if we want to evaluate the def integral of f of x from a to b, we can take the area above the x-axis and subtract the area below the x-axis. So looking at our first integral, we have the integral of f of x from 0 to 5. So we're integrating over this interval here, where we have area both above and below the x-axis. So on the interval from 0 to 3, the value of the integral would be positive 5. But then on the interval from 3 to 5, because the area is below the x-axis, the value would be negative 3. So we can either add negative 3 here or just subtract 3, giving us a value of positive 2. Next, we have the integral of f of x from 3 to 7, which would be from here to here. So notice on the interval from 3 to 5, the def integral would be negative 3 because the area is below the x-axis. So we have negative 3 and then plus. On the interval from 3 to 5, the value of the def integral would be positive 2 because the area is above the x-axis. So we have negative 3 plus 2, which is equal to negative 1. And then finally, for the last integral, we have the def integral of f of x from 0 to 7, which would be over this entire interval here. So from 0 to 3, the value would be positive 5, because the area is above the x-axis. And then from 3 to 5, the value would be negative 3, because the area is below the x-axis. So again, we can add negative 3 or just subtract 3. And then finally, from 5 to 7, because the area is above the x-axis, the value would be positive 2. So we have 5 minus 3 plus 2, which is equal to positive 4. I hope you found this helpful.